Bring your designs to life with these captivating Canva animations. In today's Canva tutorial, you'll learn exactly how to animate in Canva to grab the attention of your audience with super engaging animated content. Ready? Let's do this. Hi, my lovely people, it's Natalia and welcome back to my channel where I help you create better content and grow on social media. In today's Canva tutorial for beginners, you'll learn how to create awesome animated graphics and videos, and I'll explain all the different ways you can put elements into motion, use fun transitions, and create your own custom animations to make sure your content stands out and really engages your audience. If you love Canva and want to get even better at it, make sure you subscribe because I share easy and fun tutorials all the time. And if you learned something new in this video, hit that like button for good measure too. All right, let's jump to point number one and start animating our slides. First, let me start with the easiest way to animate in Canva, and that's using page level animations. Anytime you'd like to create a quick animation for multiple elements at once, you can simply go to the top panel in here without having anything selected on the slide you want to animate, and then click animate at the top in here, and you can then choose from the variety of different options you see in this left panel. The first section is for the preset combinations of animations that go together for various elements. As you can see with this party one in here, we've got the first bubble that kind of pops in, then the ring slides from the right, and the text shows up by animating letter after letter. Below, we have the basic styles, the exaggerated ones, and the photo movement ones, which animate all of the elements in a very similar style, like this breathe one in here. You can see that it kind of eases in our three elements. Or then we've got the stomp animation that creates a thumping vibration of sorts for all of them. For this one, I think I like the drift animation like this. If you click on it, you'll see further controls available for Canva Pro users only. If you'd like to test these out, make sure to check the link in the description box to get the Pro account for 30 days complete free of charge. I feel like it's a great option to kind of get to play with these functionalities and see if the Pro account would be useful to you. Now, from the slider right here, you can adjust the intensity so you can see that it goes kind of a bit harder, it's a bit slower. Then below, you've got the direction, so you can make it move from kind of the left, from the right, from the top, or from the bottom. Now, these controls are animation specific, meaning that each of them will have different options if you click on them, depending kind of on the style of movement. So for example, if you go to baseline right here, you can choose whether you want that animation to happen on exit, on enter, or on both. Then of course, we've got the speed in here as well, so you can make it kind of happen faster or slower, and you've got the direction as before as well. And now if you go to the block animation in here, you can see that it even allows you to choose a color. I can choose one from my palette, and it's great to stay on brand even with little small details like this. Now remember all of these different controls, because that's a universal way of interacting with the animations in the Canva editor, and it will be very similar across the board with transitions and element animations as well. Now, once you've animated the page, you can always decide against it and click remove all animations here at the bottom to revert to the static slide, or apply this style of animation to all of your pages. So again, I can click on it and go apply to all pages, and that will kind of change all of the controls for all of those animations across the board for you. Now, although page level animations are super convenient and definitely can work for kind of less complicated motion patterns, I feel like these are very basic, and it's very obvious that they were created in Canva simply because they kind of lack nuance and they're a bit more crudely animated. And this is precisely why I prefer to animate individually rather than whole pages, which is a great segue to our second style of animation, animating individual elements. At this stage, it's worth mentioning that we have a plethora of different animated elements available through the library that don't really require any work to make them move. Now, the first way to access them is through the Elements tab in the left panel under the Stickers section in here. Now, these can instantly elevate any static design and create a fun movement to make your design stand out. Now, the moment you use an animated sticker like this, you can export your designs as an MP4 video, so the motion is visible, but these are also a great addition to your videos since the animations can be a little bit more robust than our standard Canva animation functionalities. And of course, that's only a limited selection of featured animations. So the second way to find them is to search for something specific. I'll go to search for abstract. and go to this little icon in here and select animated from here, then hit apply filters. This way we're only seeing animated elements in the library. I'll go for graphics in here. And this is super useful when you already have something in mind. And these can be used as kind of overlay elements. These can be textures, it can be indicators, or simply it can be a visual cue to make your videos more engaging. And of course, I wouldn't be myself if I didn't sneak in a slightly more advanced tip here. So as a third way of finding already animated elements, you can go to elements in here, then scroll down for videos, see all, and now I can just search for green screen. Now from here, you'll access a multitude of different elements, different animations, or even footage recorded on a green screen, which makes it super easy to remove the background from in Canva. Now, once I choose something that I like, let's say this subscribe button is something that I'd like to use, I can go to edit video here at the top, then go to the effects tab and tap the background remover. It may take some time depending on the size and length of the clip. This one's pretty quick, but then you should be left with an element like this. It's super cool, but remember, not every clip is going to be ideal since the background remover is not always as precise as more advanced techniques like chroma key would be. As an important side note, the video background remover, just like our photo background remover, is a pro only option, so this won't be available to you on a free plan. All right, we've got the library of animations covered. Now let's move on to the animations available within Canva for individual elements. Here we've got three different categories. We've got text, we've got photos, and graphics. So let's start with the last one because it's the simplest one to explain. If you choose any graphic element from the library, and by the way, that's including all the animated elements I've just talked about, you can actually animate it individually. Here we have a slightly smaller selection of animations than with our page level animations, but they can be very effective, especially when we include all of the controls. I've pretty much explained how these animations work already, so I'm not going to get into it again here. This is a sneaky little new update here that I'll talk about in just a moment, so make sure to keep watching. But before we move on, I want you to know that you can also group two elements together and then animate them to create a cohesive motion. For example, these two here, so I've got the kind of bubble from below and then the circle, they both create an orb together. And let's say I don't want to create separate animations for them, but also don't want to resort to animating the whole page because I have a different vision for the text. I can just select both of them either by holding and dragging like this, or just selecting one and holding shift to add another one, and then the group option appears above. Once I click that and then select the group, you can simply animate both of them together, and this gives me the power to style the video just the way I like. This is also a great moment to introduce this small hidden trick that allows you to kind of control how certain elements appear without having to add another page. Now, let's say I want these two animate graphics to disappear before my whole slide finishes. Now, this slide takes 3.7 seconds. I may want them to just pop in for a second and a half. Now, if I right click on the element or both the elements and then click show timing in here, you're going to expand the timeline below to show the timings for these selected elements. Now, from here, you can simply shorten the duration of these elements. I can go to 1.5 for this one, 2.2, let's say, for the second one. And when you play it, you'll see them disappear before the slide runs out. It's a super cool thing to keep your timeline a bit more neater and without massive amounts of cuts. Now, you'll see from here that I keep clicking the different elements on my slide, and I'll see the preview for them change on the timeline. So it's great for kind of quick edits as well. Okay, let me quickly go to the elements tab and add a photo for you so that you can see what these animations look like for photos. I'll push it forward. And if you go to animate, you can see that we've got three extra options here for photo movement. We've got photo flow, we've got photo rise, and then we've got photo zoom. Now, these are clearly only going to work with photos, but it's good to know that this is an option here if you use photographs in your designs or videos. And also, as a side note, all of your uploads are treated as photos as well, so these animations will apply to them too. Okay, let's remove those and select our text. text, because that's probably one of the most exciting parts of animating within Canva, since we have many more options here. Now, I encourage you to just test these out for yourself with different variants too, because they're really, really cool and open up a lot of fun opportunities to create really engaging videos. Now, for example, if you look at shift here, you'll see that I can choose the writing style. So you can go for character, you can go for word level, or you can go for line level if you've got more text. So let me just add something here like this. You can see that if I click line, that's going to animate both lines here. I also really love to use merge for these kinds of texts when there are multiple lines, because it really gives this cool effect. Now, all right, we nearly have the individual animations covered, but there's one that definitely deserves a separate point because it's a brand new update, which I've shared with you last week, I think, in my new Canva features video. I highly recommend you watch it next, but for now, let's look at point number three, create an animation. This is one of those updates that definitely changed the game for me. We now have the power to create our own custom animations for each of our graphics, for text boxes, for photos, and even video clips if you want them to move a certain way. Now, let me show you how it works using the star elements. Let me go to star and find something like this. So this is actually a photo, but it's going to be perfect for this animation. Now, all you need to do is to select it, again, click animation, and then click create animation. From here, you're going to drag our element to create the path for the animation and release, and it's really as simple as that. From here, you can choose the movement styles. You can go for original motion, the smooth one, which kind of eases it in and out, and then steady for a nice and constant movement. You can also toggle orient element to path, which is going to make it follow along the line and rotate if needed, or adjust the slider for the speed. Now, if you're not happy with your animation, just click delete path here at the very bottom and start over. Now, while animating, you can also hold shift for any straight lines while animating as well. Now, when you're ready, hit done and enjoy your completely custom animation. It's completely mind-blowing to me, and it gets even better when you learn it's available on the free Canva plan as well. Okay, let's tie this thing together using transitions, which is our point number four. Every clip you've got on your timeline in Canva can be animated on entry, on exit, or both, and this gives you the power to create really fun videos or presentations with little to no effort at all. Now, to use a transition, you first need to have at least two clips. Luckily, we've got more than that. And now, if you hover over the gap between the clips, this small icon right here is popping up, which you can then tap to add your transition. Now, here, another panel pops up with a great variety of different fun transitions that you can choose from. We've got cool effects like circle wipe in here, which you can then choose the duration for. And as you can see, when I adjust the duration, it affects the duration of the clips on the timeline as well. You can make it kind of go in or go out. Really cool effects in here. You also have something that's called a color wipe. And from here, again, you can choose the different colors from your palette to stay on brand, even within your videos, for example. So that's quite a cool effect as well. We also have flow, which is really fun for these kinds of videos, but I want to highlight one transition to literally rule them all: match and move. Now, what it does is that it allows you to create an animation between the same elements appearing on two or more different slides. Okay, let's take this little star again. I'll just copy it to the next slide in here and make it a little bit smaller, maybe I'll rotate it like this, and then let's copy it again and paste it in our third slide. Let's make it even smaller and rotate it, and maybe I'll put it kind of right next to the E just for fun. Now let's add our transitions between those clips. So match and move in here, and match and move in there as well. Let's go back to the very beginning. And as you can see, Canva understands that it's the same element that it has to move around for us to create seamless transition between these slides. Now, to show you how much you can actually do with it, let me jump to a different video created just to show you the power of animations in here. Now, all of these different holographic bubbles and the text are animated using the match and move transition. I've turned them in different directions. I've moved them around. I made the text rotate. I changed the angles for the headlines to make them appear and disappear from various spots. And most of it was possible thanks to this transition only. Of course, this whole short video came together using all the different animation styles I've shown you in this video. Because for example, at the very beginning, this is a custom animation. Then there are different text animations. All of it was created with a simple vision in mind that Canva helped me bring to life. Now, speaking of this video, I had an idea to actually show you a step-by-step guide on how to recreate this animation. Now, I always show you how to use different Canva functionalities. I share tips and tricks to kind of empower you to produce better content and discover your creative voice more. But I feel like a huge part of it is to actually practice. Now, I know I learned much, much quicker when I started recreating different designs and then only fleshing out my own ideas. So I thought a format like this where I guide you on how to create a specific design might be helpful to you. Now, let me know in the comments if this is something you'd be interested in. I'd love to hear your opinion if it would be a fun thing for you to do along with me here. Now, I'll also be sharing a YouTube short very shortly on how to create your own green screen effect animations to use in your videos if you're editing in different software and need to make these custom animations. So make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell to see more exciting content like this from me. And make sure to watch this playlist right now to improve your Canva skills and learn new fun ways of designing engaging content. It was super fun to hang out with you here today, so thank you for being with me, and I'll see you next time.